San Marino seats inside this Rolls truck, they Dolphin blue. Big homie, y'all little boys better remember who y'all talking it's to. It's gonna cost you like a 50 for me and the gang, and we just walking through. We count money often too.
We are pleased, as always, to be bringing you coverage of the National Football League on EA Sports. It's all about divisional matchups on this final day of the regular season, and we've got a compelling one in store here, as it'll be the Carolina Panthers taking on the Atlanta Falcons. Kicker Brian Johnson out there to get us started.
And this one is underway here on EA Sports.
And this will go as a touchback, and they will begin things at the 25.
You know it all day.
This could be it. This could be the turning point.
Woo! Woo!
Keep the ball moving. Keep the ball moving.
Ball to Grant.
Right now.
Run that ball down the field.
Even you offense.
Come on,
offense.
Come on.
Let's get a few
yards
on this play. Let's get out of here with a win.
Here's Ritter now to throw the first play. And they're able to get this one across the 35. That's a pickup of 11 and a first down on their first offensive play.
Well, this defense certainly knows they're going to have their hands full trying to slow down this passing game. Here's an example. On the very first play from scrimmage, I think we'll see some different looks, maybe some pressure from different places, but it didn't work there, and it's a quick first down.
They're winding up getting right at four there on the scramble, and it's second down. These two teams, they met up earlier in the year, back in week two. And it was the Falcons getting the road victory in that one. So they'll look to finish off the season sweep here in Atlanta. On second down, Ritter. That's out wide here for Robinson. And he'll maybe get back to the line of scrimmage, but no more than that. The Panthers turn to their nickel set here as they get ready for third down. Ritter to throw it. He's going to get that to his running back out of the backfield. And he's going to have a Falcons first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Two first downs have him up near midfield now on first and 10.
Downfield offense.
A run for the first time of Bijan Robinson. And he stopped immediately there. Brian Burns, the one to bring him down. The Falcons at 11-5 on the year. Now, they were losers last time out, trying to turn things around here in this one.
And it always helps to have a home crowd behind you, giving you encouragement as long as you give them something good to cheer about. So, you know, they just want to come out and play well for their faithful. They expect them to do just that.
He's going to go out of bounds, but he takes this one down just shy of the 20. That one covers 29 yards. First down. Working from the gun, Ritter. This to Pitts, and he's got him. Touchdown, Atlanta. Touchdown, here's Koo to kick off. And from back there, a wise move. He'll just sit on this one, and it'll come out to the 25.
Chance to settle down.
stops, Ethan.
Miles Sanders' first carry of the game. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. 2 yards on the pickup, and that's all they needed to move the sticks.
Second and one is often an invitation to take the big shot downfield. I bet the offensive lineman said, are you kidding? We just get on our backs, and let's go get the first down. They love being physical.
Counting down toward the midway point in corner one. A quick throw complete to Chark. And they will only muster a yard here to the 38. You talk about this Falcon defense. They find themselves just a couple of spots outside of the top 10 defending the pass, number 12 in the league.
I think if you talk to the head coach, you'll get a nice answer about how much he likes his team and what they're doing. But then at the end of it, he would admit there's definitely room to improve.
Second down, Young. Thomas has got it. Complete. And they will only muster a yard here.
The completion there is the zone defense is coming. Catching the ball. Let's run after that.
They'll be in search of 8 yards here as they hope to convert the first down.
Play some defense out there, fellas.
Here's Young from the shotgun. Look in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And he is going to have a Panthers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. They clearly wanted to come out, Charles, and be aggressive throwing the football, and they've been pretty efficient along with that aggressiveness. He's now 4-4 on this opening drive.
Yeah, that's led to a fresh set of downs. I like what he's doing back there. You can tell he's at ease, feels good about what he's doing.
Inside the 45 before going out of bounds. He'll wind up getting 9 after tucking it and running, so it'll leave him with 2nd and a yard. Quite a bit of the short passing game here early on first quarter, haven't we?
We have, and I think it works a couple of ways for this team because, number one, you throw a short game until they stop it, and if they're not going to stop it, you keep throwing it, and occasionally you'll break a tackle and turn into a bigger game.
Trying to set the screen, and it's intercepted. Picked off by A.J. Turner. Here now, 2nd and 4. Now Ritter going to change up the look. The tight end in motion right. 2nd down and a run by Robinson. And he is met at the line of scrimmage and he goes down right there. No gain on the play that time, and they'll look to convert on what will be a 3rd and 4. But you look at this defense, and they're a unit that struggled some against the run, no doubt, coming in 25th out of 32 teams.
And the focus now is making sure that they're hitting on all cylinders as they head into the playoffs. And that means they've got to stop the run better. Because playoff football often means running football. So they've got to be prepared for that.
First time these two have hooked up this afternoon, and it's a first down. Final 30 seconds of this first quarter, and it's been a quarter dominated by the guys with the football. And he'll get across midfield and into Carolina territory.
Really?
Getting 5 on the carry there, and it'll be 2nd down.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
From the 46, here's the 2nd and 5. Straight ahead, it's Robinson. And it'll be a minimum pickup here as it will take us to the end of the first quarter. After 1-7-0 on EA Sports.
Third and four. Ritter will set up to throw it. Oh, tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. And he'll take this across midfield and inside the 45. So this defense coming up with a takeaway, and maybe that's something that can bring a little life to that sideline.
Well, I don't want to say that they've been sleepwalking through this first half, because that's simply not true, but you're right. We haven't seen a lot of fire from these guys, really, on either side of the ball. So maybe that's the catalyst that they needed to get them back into this game.
Following the interception, Young. And it's a short one here. Completes tight. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6. A big pickup of 38.
I can hear the film session right now. I can hear the coach saying to his team, guys, how does a guy that big get that open?
Yeah, that's what I was wondering. Imagine him as a kid, just trying to play hide and seek.
No chance.
No chance. He goes to hide behind the skinny tree. You see the front, the back, the top. Good luck.
Yeah, you see him. You don't see the tree.
They'll run with Sanders. Looking for a seam, but finding none. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. No gain on the play that time, and it sets up second and goal.
Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description, because diagnosed is perfect on that. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
Escaping the pressure low. So with the missed PAT in his rearview mirror, he goes back out to kick this one off. And Smith not going to bring it out, so it's a touchback. The Atlanta offense out there for their next drive. And they, if you just look at this game, Charles, on paper, they've got the edge, no doubt. They're hanging around the top of the NFC. On the other side, you got a squad that's towards the bottom of the NFC. But when we mentioned that to the coaches, they were having no part of it.
Yeah, and I like how you said when we mentioned it. In fact, I mentioned it, and I upset them a little bit, didn't I? Because they wanted no part of that one, and I was reminded, like a five-year-old, this is the NFL. Any given Sunday, anything can happen. They are guarding against the upset.
Back to throw, Ritter. Targeting Pitts on the out route, and he's got it complete. And Pitts is going to pick up a Falcons first down as he'll be brought down at the 38-yard line.
And the tight end is certainly a position built to move the chains, because they can control space underneath. If they've got good hands, then of course they're a dynamic target. But one other thing is they're right in the sight lines of a quarterback on just about every play. And that makes it easier for the quarterback to kick him out and deliver.
Forced out to his left. And he tosses this one incomplete. Seeing no options, he throws it away.
I see the surprise in your face there, partner. That is a rare incompletion from him. He's been on point this entire game.
He has percentage completion-wise way up. Not that time. Off the play fake. It's Ritter. That's going to be caught by Pitts. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40.
So the ball moves from 138 to the other as they come up on first and 10.
Not three. See, that's the struggle. Six off.
Going play action. Into the hands of London. And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the five all the way to the three. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. Another throw coming up here for Reader. And he whips that one incomplete there. Not sure what happened out there, but it looked like the timing was a little off on that throw.
Well, you're my defender, so what am I going to say?
Great defense.
I'm darn right. They did something to disrupt that timing.
Reader, he wants to change the play here.
Come on, fellas, we need this. Let's do it.
Black open.
To the end zone, but it's incomplete.
Really? Are you kidding me?
Down the hatches to the defensive line. Dodge two contacts to the end zone. Not what do you think they're trying to dial up on third and goal?
Well, knowing them and knowing what we just seen, I think they're throwing it again, don't you?
I think you have to. I think in this situation, you've kind of run out of your running plays. Fire another one into the end zone.
Reader completes his quickly. To run with it. A fair catch will move this out to the 25-yard line.
Here we go.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive as we grind toward the end of the season here, and they haven't had the season that they had hoped. So let me ask you to play GM. Where might they look to make some changes?
I think when you look into the upcoming draft, think hard about them drafting multiple offensive linemen. They've got to get stacked right front. And as a GM, it always tells me, Charles, this is a big boy league, and big people always end up winning games for you.
They go play action. Open man is Mingo at the three. Across the 40 before he's out of bounds. 15 yards there for number 15.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
And Young's throw there incomplete. And Charles, you look at this defense. They were a very loose group coming into the week, knowing they kind of had the upper hand going into this one, taking on a team that hasn't won in a month and a half.
And that works well for you if you establish your dominance early in the game against a team that's struggling. But if somehow they fashion some plays together early, not for the defense, that was used against them. To shadow him across the
field. The chart goes in motion left. He's going to get it on the jet sweep. This one, it may need to go back to the drawing board. He's going to be swallowed up right away. 2 yards the loss, second and 12. That's the danger, Charles, of running plays like this for your wide receiver. They can hit big or they can be duds.
Yeah, you're exactly right about that, because if they're forced to try and go around defenders behind the line of scrimmage, sometimes you can give yardage in order to gain it. But in this case, they gave yardage and didn't get it back.
Flushed out right. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be.
Defense!
He was looking for one. Defense! Once again, it seems to be a pocket.
possession.
A long way to go here on third down for the eighth play of the drive. Young will set to throw. He's got his target. That's complete. And that's going to be good for another first down as the tackle's made at the Falcon 16. 19 yards that time for number 19. So he turned to a trusted, familiar face in that third down situation. It paid off.
Yeah, you go to your veteran receiver in that spot, so you can't underestimate him when he's on the field. Defensively, make sure you know where he is because he understands how to get open in key situations.
So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. Young to throw it. Throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete.
Here's a good opportunity to just run a drop pass. I guess that's why they call them running backs and not catching backs.
Young's incompletion on first down leads to a second and 10. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. And he comes back with one complete. And the Panthers are going to have a first and goal coming up as the tackle made at the 3-yard line.
And this has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against them a few minutes ago because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there, and they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
Sanders will struggle to get to the line of scrimmage as he'll be tackled back at the 4-yard line. Now the Falcons going to use one of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play.
Showtime, let's make some noise.
Have come back to make it a 2-point game. A nice throw there by the second-year quarterback.
And I don't believe that was the kind of play you would have made as a rookie, because usually your rookie season is a continuation of your college days. A lot of one read, and if you don't have it, you just take off and go. Now he's settled in the pocket a little bit more, reading the field and getting to a second and sometimes third progression. That was a nice play.
And now he's got to go down. Here's Johnson set and ready to kick this one away. Fair catch going to be taken, and this will be moved out to the 25. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And still plenty of time remaining here in the half, more than a minute. And we'll see if they just want to protect that lead or try to add on to it.
Well, with as much time as is left on the clock, I would imagine it would be the latter. I think they're going to try and add on to it. So what they're going to tell the team is very simply, if you can get out of bounds after making a play downfield, terrific. If you can't, everyone hustle to the line of scrimmage, either run another play or clock it and start over again.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Ritter back to throw. That's out wide here for Robinson. He's upended after a gain of 2 out to the 27.
Oh, it's time to give a little credit there to the defense. They played that very well because it was a drag route, and he ran it a little shallower than normal as he worked straight across the field. He was hoping he'd get lost behind the defensive line, but once he made the catch, nowhere to turn upfield and gain any yardage.
I want six, not three.
Defense is asleep.
Ritter throwing on third down. There he is, caught. The Falcons going to use the second of their timeouts as they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half.
Here we go.
Let's build that momentum.
Right, boys?
Get in the pocket. Come on, be patient.
On first down, Ritter. it's incomplete.
The coverage keyed in on him since that last completion his way. And that made it a lot tougher to get a clean throw his way.
Here's second and 10. Robinson up the middle. Oh, the return is going to take this all the way down near the 40. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. Ritter looking to throw on first and 10. And a big loss here as he's taken down. Falcons going to use their third and final timeout as they'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to go in this first half.
Keep it up. Your ball, baby.
On the ready.
Now this one from about two counties over after the sack. They come up on a second and very long.
So
Ritter now. And that is a heck of a catch as he was able to get both feet in.
Tight ends just use their size and their strength, try to occupy some space and kind of body people away and catch the football. But not this guy. He's a refined route runner. Makes me wonder if he took some dance classes in his background with his footwork.
And I tell you what, he got it from 50. Let's go, Falcons! Let's go, Falcons! Let's go, Falcons!
What a luxury it is to have a kicker you can depend upon, partner, because he hasn't missed all year long. Converts on that one as well, and kudos to you. You didn't jinx him.
And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. And they'll have time for one play. That's it. 3 seconds to go before intermission. A good run there to start the drive. 13 yards, first down. And that'll do it for the end of the second quarter. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports.
Oh, man, come on!
And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. The Panthers going to get the football first, trailing here as well as we resume play in this second half. This will be brought out for the middle of the end zone. And not a good return here at all as they'll be forced to start at the 12-yard line.
For most people, the excitement of a kickoff return is to see a long one that goes back in the opposite direction. But for the guys covering it, it's being able to stop them deep in their own territory. How about that incredible form tackle right there? Shoulder in the ball carrier, and down he goes.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. This offense, Charles, had a strong first half throwing the football, at least in terms of yardage, but that hasn't translated so far on the scoreboard as they begin the third quarter here, trailing and looking for a little momentum.
Yeah, you're right about that because, you know, let's face it, in the first half, most of their focus was in the passing game, and to their credit, resulted in a healthy amount of yardage. So I would think that at halftime, they're going to anticipate that defense loosening up a little bit to try and cover the passing lanes. They've got to get the running game going, and there should be some gaps to run through now.
They'll run with Sanders at the middle. And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple, and that's it.
I have to think a major focus of the halftime means had to be figuring out how to create space for the running game to get operated.
Well, what you pointed out to me at half seems accurate. That line has struggled to sustain blocks.
Yeah, I would agree with that totally. They've got to focus on staying on their double teams at the first level, make sure that block's secured before they slide off and try and chip someone at the second level.
Young working out of the gun. Pressure brought in. Get there for the sack.
Defense!
A loss of nine. They seem to have a reason for the time in the pocket. Couldn't get rid of the football. Result, Charles, him on the ground.
Yeah, he's got to keep an internal clock to go along with his offensive line. You're talking about 3, 4, 5 seconds. That's a reasonable amount of time to expect to deliver the ball downfield. So great to try to complete a pass. It's equally important to know when to throw the ball to the right.
Young incomplete.
And so many times we look at the opening. tone setter, and many coaches do emphasize it. And that's a strong performance there defensively to force incompletion and, more importantly, force a quick punting situation.
Oh, and what a play on special teams here. This is going to be down inside the five, all the way down at the 2-yard line.
And he's got to be fired up about that effort. I don't think he could have walked down and placed it any better than where he ended up putting the football. That was excellent.
The Atlanta offense out there for their next drive. We have not seen much on offense here from either side these last few drives. They hit a wall, so to speak.
Because the defenses right now, they seem to be a step ahead, don't they? Beating them to the point of attack, beating them to the punch. These offensive guys are tinkering like crazy. What's it going to take to get back on track?
Yeah, both sides searching for adjustments. Oh, nice throw here, right side. He holds it in.
What am I doing?
Way up past
the
35. He's taken down. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down. Hand off to Robinson out of the shotgun. And space tough to come by there as he'll get maybe a yard to the 37. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
On second, here's Algier. And he went nowhere. Well, he went backwards, back to the 33. That's going to go down as a loss of five, and it brings up third down.
I really like what he did there because he took his practice work and converted it to game action because he used his hands, got off the block, worked laterally and stayed to the outside, and finished off the runner for a loss.
Gonna need a crafty play call here. 14 yards is what they need to try to convert this thing. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Pass taken in by his good tight end. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Panthers' 44-yard line. A big play there as they get the conversion on third and 13. Ritter going to change it up. He's got his man on the to run with it, and a fair catch on the kickoff will move the ball to the 25. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. And Charles, a very uninspired effort the last time we saw them out there. It was a quick three and out, then they punted the football.
Yeah, and you never want to get stopped so suddenly during the series, but it'll be even worse now. It's letting it happen again right here. They've got to get going.
Call it a gain of six on the play, and it'll be second down.
Play some defense out there, fellas.
Now here's Young. Oh, that's into a sea of bodies, and it's intercepted. A first and 10 at the 38. A give to Robinson on the option. And maybe a little over pursuit there as he's able to take this down to the 25-yard line. 14 yards there and a Falcon first down.
Muscle damage has been done through the air. I mean, they've rung the bell three times with passes. passing touchdowns, but guess what? Ground game has not been neglected. Nice little burst right there.
Ready.
I want to see some points out there.
Keep it rolling.
Ritter on first and 10. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8 yard gain, second and 2.
Timing is so important on a route like this because he's going to line up out right and then cut straight across the field. I think the ball might have come out a count or two too late because by the time he was able to secure it, not much of a chance to turn it upfield.
Now a second and 2.
Get in there.
Come on, fellas. You can score. Come on, man.
Ritter will set up to throw it.
Downfield.
It's a loss of a yard there, and it's second down.
And now defensively, you have to look at this like the game's on the line. It's just the third quarter, but another touchdown given up here could really spell an end to their chances. So they need to toughen up and keep them out of the end zone.
Back at the 5 yard line now, second and goal. Algier going straight ahead. Allen gets in. Touchdown. Tyler Algier, his second rushing touchdown of the year. And the Falcons are able to extend their lead. Crew able to connect on the extra point. And that will make this a 19-point game. And they'll accept that penalty. After the roughing penalty on the PAT, they'll kick off from 15 yards further upfield. And he's only going to make it to the 13-yard line and no further.
In this position, trying to get back into the game, teams are looking for a stop from their special teams. That's not what they got, though. They got a setback, and they have a long field to cover if they want to try and put points on the board.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. It's a game that they would rather probably forget about, at least to this point, Charles. And one reason is turnovers. A turnover on the last drive. They had the issue in the first half as well. And that's really, unfortunately for them, helped to put this game out of reach.
And you know they want to admit it to themselves. But we know that winning the game is pretty much out of the picture now. So their bottom line is, how do they play a clean game the rest of this one, right? Take care of the football, no more turnovers, and see how that works.
Do it. Hold him on the line.
On second down, Young. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line.
What are we doing?
He's up to 70 yards receiving now as that last catch gets him a first down.
And that's why defensive coaches preach swarming to the football. It's usually going to take more than one guy to get that big man down.
And it did right there. Multiple broken tackles, but they eventually get him down. A first down throw for Young. He's able to get this to the 40-yard line before he's out of bounds. 28 yards the gain there on the catch and run.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open, just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space, and it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
Meanwhile, the
throw by Young was knocked away and incomplete.
And not a common sight, at least on this drive. A momentary setback, though, for this passing game that has been moving well this series. Good thing for them, though. Still two more downs to connect and try and pick up another first down.
Young's incompletion on first down leads to a second and 10. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. Too far in front. He couldn't reel it in. It's
incomplete.
The end zone
is
they just got caught. Play call. Get their offense back on track.
This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have them looking at third and 10. Young. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. They take advantage, turn that into a pick six.
And that defense is in a spot now where they're thinking about ways to close this game out. And as confidently as they've been playing, I expect them to do exactly that.
Now Young Wei-Ku for the extra point. Now he's been a busy man, 5 for 5 to extend the lead. And they won't be able to run another play. Time has expired. On this third quarter, you're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Here's Koo to kick it off. Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. We certainly had a sense coming in here that these guys were in for a tough one on the road. That has been how this ball game has played out. They trail big as we continue on now here in this fourth quarter. Officially, it's a 1 yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11. The chart goes in motion left. To throw, Young. And he drops it incomplete. And struggles continue here.
This second
no points allowed. And you can add another to the total number that they forced in this runaway contest.
Young on third down. Flush to his right, and he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. Danielle Hunter able to get in there for his second sack of the afternoon. Here's Johnny Hecker now as the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away.
Shut it down!
Yeah!
And they will get to this one and down it at the 13-yard line.
I don't know why, but it's always agonizing to me to see a guy make a mistake in this phase of the game because you can it's all on him. All eyes there. He's got a chance to make a punt return, and instead, he ends up putting it on the carpet.
Puts it on the carpet. The little rubber pellets shoot up. Never a good sign for a returner on this field turf surface.
No, not at all. And a bunch of them go up when they're all trying to get to the football, don't they?
About set to begin their next drive. The Falcons offense at the line. First down, and they'll start with Algier. And he's brought down, but not before they get it across the 20-yard line. 10 yards there to start the drive, and just enough by about the length of the football for a first down.
Well, partner, I know this type of running back. I mean, this size, this intensity usually gets better as the game goes on. And I just tell you from experience, the first few quarters, oh, you're eager. You come running up there. I'm going to tackle this guy. By the fourth quarter, you're kind of thinking about it.
And D-line wearing down fourth quarter. Yeah, that's not a guy I want to see consistently.
It'll be a gain of 5, and that will bring up second down.
That one.
Ultra, ultra.
Now a toss left side for Algier. Fighting through. So they accept the penalty, of course, and push the offense backwards a bit.
Play here, offense. Big play.
Blue check.
He's moving.
Trying the left side with Algier. Call it a gain of 4, and it'll leave him with a third down and 6 to go.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down the game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
It's a big play there for Atlanta. 47 yards.
And even with the game seemingly in hand, they're continuing to fire away, pressing the ball down the field. Listen, it's worked all day. No reason to go away from it now.
On the double.
On first and 10, it's Algier. He's able to work free for about 6 down to the 18.
I think we all suspected that they were going back to him after he found the end zone on his last carry. And they kept the positive momentum going there. Another nice run by him.
Here's Algier again on second down. Give him a yard on the run there, and that's going to set up a third down and 2.
Really good run defense when you're playing a 3-4. Those three guys up front, the nose tackle and the guys they call the defensive ends, they're usually big, big people because they're going to have to eat up a lot of blockers because it's usually 5-on-3. And when they do their job well, guys who play on the inside, those inside linebackers, they will just roam and hit.
The CD, they're up big, but they're still passing it. I mean, this is an offense that's had a lot of success in this game, and it seems like they're just having fun out there.
And it does feel like there's been a shift out there, doesn't it, partner? Listen, you can continue to do what you want to do. It's up to the other team to make you change how you do things. They'll continue to throw it around until stopped.
Well, we kind of looked at each other as they decided to go for it, but in the end, great execution, a 6-yard gain, and it all works out. So this drive going to continue following the conversion on fourth. Here's first and 10.
Ready.
Algier now up the middle. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. It outside, but no success.
Yeah, sometimes you got to just figure out where you're going to go, and sometimes you just have to take it to another spot. And trying to get it outside, the defensive pursuit was there and just ran him down.
Here's Algier again on second down, and he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. So it's the big left tackle who gets tagged with a hold.
And sometimes you're actually executing the block well, and he starts to slip off of you, and instinctively you reach out and grab him. And when it's done like that, it's often seen by the official and called.
Option play, here's Robinson. Oh, some strong running. And they are going to score again. Yet another touchdown as they just added their targets. Kuhn out for the point after. And this one was over a while ago as they just added. Touchdown, here's Kuhn to kick off. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. Where we stand right now in the fourth quarter, this one pretty much out of reach. And Charles, I know they're going to be disappointed about several things with this ball game, but the self-inflicted wounds. They've had several turnovers. You would have to think that's going to be something they're going to discuss heavily in the film session in the coming days.
I'm not sure about that, partner, because they're going to have to sit in that film room and watch every error that they made and figure out how to not do it in the future. And mentally, I think a lot of the guys are already starting to think about, okay, how do we put this behind us and get better for the next time out? This they'll use as motivation for the rest of the time that they play to hopefully never be in this type of situation again.
One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10.
Ready.
Young. And out of bounds on the other side of midfield at the 35. Another nice gain. That's now 30 yards between those last two plays. So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. Looking to throw, Young. He completes this one. Now he's going to get this inside the 30. Give him back-to-back catches now. That one for 16. And another first down. Again, it's Young. From the outside, on target to field. As he's in for the touchdown, but they still trail big time.
He'll take it, but he won't be able to smile about it.
This time, the extra point up and good. And that trims the lead a bit, but still standing at 26 points. Here's Johnson set and ready to kick this one away. But no run back here. Fair catch, and this will come out to the 25. Clock counting down toward 40 seconds as they take the knee.
Hey, that's what we do. That's what we do. Yeah. Yeah. Woo.
Go, go, go.
Take that. Thank you.
Charles, a lot of happy faces heading into the tunnel as this one ends. And understandably so, not only did they get the win, but boy, their offense was on fire in this ballgame.
And partner, I have no idea what the top speed is on one of those high-end sports cars, what's the top gear you can get into. This offense, they certainly were there in this one, huh? Everything clicking for them in this contest, the kind of performance that they're going to cherish.
So for the Falcons, they finish off the regular season at 12 up and 5 down. And now they'll await the final seeding for the playoffs ahead. Meanwhile, for Carolina, they go out with a bit of a whimper as they wrap up a very trying 3-14 season. And it's fair to say wholesale changes will be forthcoming in the very near future. So for Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. Next game, guess what? Charles...
You be in your zone when you winning on your own. When you winning, wake up, look out the window.
could tell I'm committed. This get hard and I get it, but long as you stay authentic, you'll be destined to win it. I recreated my image. This was earned, never given. Gonna be that way till it's finished. Cause you be in your zone.